3.4, in which question number 5, prove that an equilateral triangle is equiangular. I draw the triangle ABC, which is equilateral triangle. Given, triangle ABC is an equilateral. What to prove? Equiangular. Triangle ABC is an equiangular. Equiangular means all the angles are equal. Now, proof. Triangle ABC is an equilateral. This is given. Therefore, segment AB congruent to segment BC congruent to segment AC. All sides are equal. I write equation first, statement first. Now, in triangle ABC, segment AB congruent segment BC, I write from first. In triangle ABC, segment AB congruent to segment BC means two sides are congruent. If two sides of a triangle are congruent, then its opposite angles also congruent. AB, its opposite angle, angle C, means angle ACB congruent BC, its opposite angle BAC, angle BAC. Isosceles triangle theorem. Equation 2. Similarly, in triangle ABC, from first I write segment BC congruent to segment AC, from first. Therefore, BC, its opposite angle is A, angle BAC, congruent AC, opposite angle is angle ABC. If two sides are congruent, then its opposite angles also congruent. Again, by isosceles triangle theorem, from 2 and 3, angle BAC, angle BAC same means angle ACB, angle ABC same means all three angles are equal. Therefore, angle ACB congruent to angle BAC congruent to angle ABC. Therefore, all the angles are congruent. Therefore, triangle ABC is an equiangular. Hence, it proved. Now, question number 6. Prove that if the bisector of angle BAC of triangle ABC is perpendicular to side BC, then triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. From this statement, I draw the triangle ABC, in which bisector of angle BAC, angle BAC, that is AD, means AD is bisector of angle BAC, and this AD is perpendicular to side BC. This is given. From that, to prove here, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Proof. In figure, by this bisector ray AD, this triangle is dividing two parts, means two triangles, triangle ADB and triangle ADC. Therefore, I write in triangle ADB and triangle ADC. Angle BAD congruent angle CAD, because ray AD is bisector of angle BAC. This is given. Again, segment AD congruent to segment AD. In both triangle, AD is the common side. Angle ADB, angle ADB, right angle, angle ADC, also right angle, angle ADB, congruent angle ADC, each 90 degree or each right angles. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by angle side angle. Therefore, triangle ADB congruent triangle ADC by ASA test. Two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding remaining elements also congruent. AB, therefore I write segment AB congruent to segment AC, corresponding sides of congruent triangle. In triangle ABC, I name this equation this first. In triangle ABC, segment AB congruent to segment AC from first. Therefore, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, hence it is proved. Question number 7, figure is given, in which in triangle PQR, segment PR congruent to segment PQ. This is given. To prove PS, segment PS greater than segment PQ. Now, proof. In triangle PQR, upon triangle PQR madhe gela, segment PQ congruent to segment PR, segment PR congruent to segment PQ, given. Two sides are congruent, therefore its opposite angles, angle PQR congruent angle PRQ, isosceles triangle theorem. PR its opposite angle, angle PQR, PQ its opposite angle, angle PRQ, are also congruent. Two sides are congruent, then opposite angles also congruent, is called isosceles triangle theorem. First statement I write this. Now, angle PRQ, this angle PRQ is an exterior angle of triangle PRS. Angle PRQ is an exterior angle of triangle PRS. And you know exterior angle theorem, the measure of exterior angle is greater than its remote interior angle. Angle S, angle P are the remote interior angles. I write here angle PRQ greater than angle PSR, exterior angle theorem. Therefore, instead of PRQ, here PRQ, angle PRQ and angle PQR equals, I write it angle PQR greater than angle PSR. Equation statement 2, from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, angle PQR greater than angle PSR, that is angle PQR, I write angle PQS, QRS between S, angle PQS greater than PSR, angle PSR, you also write this angle PSQ, angle PSQ, reason QRS between S. Now, in triangle PQS, these three, angle PQS greater than angle PSQ, from 3, where is in figure PQS, this angle Q is greater than angle S, means angle Q, its opposite side PS. Angle S, opposite side PQ, means PS is greater than PQ. Therefore, PS greater than PQ. You write the reason here. Side opposite to greater angle is greater. Hence, you write here segment PS greater than segment PQ. Now, last question number 8. In triangle ABC, segment AD, segment BE are altitudes given. AE is equal to BD, this is given. To prove segment AD congruent to segment BE. Now, in triangle ADB, this triangle ADB, and I take first triangle ADB, second triangle BEA, triangle BEA. It shows these two triangles are congruent. Angle ADB congruent angle BEA, each right angles or each 90 degree, because AD perpendicular to BC, BE perpendicular to AC. Again, in ADB, this BD, segment BD congruent to, in BEA AE segment AE. This is given. And in ADB, AB, BEA AB common side in both the triangles. AB is the common side, means AB is a hypotenuse. In ADB, angle D 90, AB is hypotenuse. In BEA, angle E 90 degree, therefore AB is a hypotenuse. Hypotenuse AB congruent to hypotenuse AB common side. Therefore, triangle ADB congruent triangle BEA. By which test? Hypotenuse side test. These two triangles are congruent by hypotenuse side test. Therefore, two triangles are congruent. Their remaining corresponding elements also congruent. AD, BE. Segment AD congruent to segment BE. Reason, corresponding sides of congruent triangle. This you prove here. Thank you.